Hi, this is a short video that I'm doing replacing the class I will not be able to make. So in this video, I will review briefly the theory behind the holistic models, and then we'll have a second video showing how to actually work those models and obtain estimates of the maximum sustainable yield using the holistic models from Schaeffer and from Fox. So let's start with the theory part. Go to show you the presentations. I will now share my screen. Good. So, first of all, some bibliography, some references. So, in the presentation that you can download in Moodle, you will have the links to these, which are the basic books, references that we will be using throughout the practical part of this course to follow us in the exercises that we will do. Okay, so there are links there, you can download this. It's already been also put in Moodle. So the whole idea of fish stock assessment is that there is a relationship between the fishing effort and the captures, in the sense that in an initial phase, the more you fish, the more you catch. That's logical, but that's true only up to a point. The idea, of course, is that you don't fish just one day, so you fish every day. You don't fish just one year, you fish year after year after year, and so it becomes a problem of sustainability. And that's why these models are also called equilibrium models, because they assume that there is an equilibrium between fishing effort and the recomposition of the stock by the growth mechanisms of the fish themselves. And so I was saying that there is an initial phase where the more we fish, the more we capture, but then this relationship tends to fall down, meaning that if you increase, as you increase the fishing effort, the captures will decrease because the fish population will just not be able to keep up with the removal of biomass. And therefore, for larger fishing efforts, captures will decrease. Right? So there is the whole idea is that the fishing effort, this is always represented by F. You see here, there is a fishing effort that maximizes sustainably the yield, right? So there's a fishing effort that produces the maximum sustainable yield, and we need to try to come up with an estimate of how much we should fish to ensure that we are fishing at the maximum sustainable yield or below that. We've just discussed that. So, very basically, what you have is, of course, the relationship may change, and therefore there may be, you need models that take into account this variability. So on the most basic level, we need catch per unit effort data. So we need to have the yield, and we need to add the effort. And we'll be talking about these holistic models or these equilibrium models, or they're also called surplus production models. And we're going to see why in a minute. But the point is, these holistic models only require catch per unit effort data. After this, we will see that these are very rough models, very basic models. When there's no other data, they have to be used. But much more accurate, much more sensitive models can be built, but these require biological data. So we'll leave that to another class. So we're going to focus on, if all you have is catch per unit effort data, how can you estimate the fishing mortality that will give you the maximum sustainability? Now, I would like to open a parenthesis here to see that, to say that this is a research opportunity, right? And so for biologists that are maybe interested in a career in fish assessment, there is research to be done here. So this is not just an issue of technical calculations. This requires research, and there is research in basically two areas, I would say. One of them is stock delimitation, right? So looking for the stock cannot be, stock management needs a stock definition, and this cannot be only a political definition or a practical definition. It has to be a biological definition. And so there's ongoing research about defining the stock and the stock limits. And this is currently being based mostly on DNA analysis. The other area of research has to do with the data that is necessary to fill the gaps and be able to use analytical models. So we need data on the ecology of fish, we need data on the biology of fish, age, growth, reproduction, and of course, the estimation of fishing and mortality and recommendations for fish stock assessment is also a research area. And so there are people working on this sector. And this should be something that could interest some of you. So now let's get to the real issue of the theory behind holistic models. So the basic idea is shown in this graph. And it's, as we've seen, and you must recall what we talked about in when we talk about the population dynamics and the fact that all populations, including fish populations, have a tendency for exponential growth on one hand, but then they will face limits and they will have to come up with the carrying capacity of the system, right? So the idea then is that in a given year, you have, at the beginning of the year, you have a certain biomass, and here these models ignore that there are fish that are small and fish that are big. They're just looking at the stock and imagining that the stock is composed of fish that are all the same, they're all the same size. So we're just talking about stock biomass, right? But the idea then is that the biomass at the beginning of a year will be reduced during that year from natural causes, right? But at the same time, fish will reproduce and will grow. And so on one hand, you have issues, you have factors decreasing the biomass, and you have factors increasing the biomass. And the increase in biomass has to be, by definition, larger than what can be sustained. And therefore, there is going to be a mortality, including in that surplus production, right? So these two diagrams show two situations of the same general rule in two situations. One where this particular species has a high productivity, and another situation where the species has a low productivity. Say, we're talking about the shark that reproduces in small numbers, right? So the capacity and grows slowly. So, but in any of these cases, the general idea is the same. Every year, there's a net production that is lost to natural mortality, right? So that the population is, the stock is constant through time, right? Lots of assumptions there. We're not going to look at them now, but we must keep them in mind for the future. Now, the concept is that if we add fishing mortality, we would be capturing some of this biomass that is lost anyway for natural causes. And so this next diagram shows a little bit of this, right? It shows the, gives you the idea that for stocks to, stocks can be kept ideally uniformly in a sustainable way with a given biomass by fishing, and that this fishing will replace natural mortality in the sense that it will decrease natural mortality with human caused mortality, fish mortality. And we have a situation here where the fishing is being done at the maximum sustainable yield. And if you also remember from the assumptions of the logistic model, these maximum sustainable yield should be around the situation where stock biomass is half of the so-called virgin biomass, the stock biomass before there was any fishing. Again, the two situations in a species that has a high net production, the captures would be higher. In a species that has low net production, captures would be lower. But the point is that there is this equilibrium, right? So how does this translate into real situation? And we're going to do this exercise later. Let's just look at it from the concepts. Now, these are real data, old data, but real data from a fishery. And you have data from fishing effort. Here, the fishing effort is done in number of boats, and the yield, right? And you see that captures, the yield was more or less constant between 40 and 60,000 tons per year, although the fishing effort was substantially different, right? So you could say, well, doesn't matter how much you fish, you will always capture the same thing. Well, that's not the correct way of looking at things, because if you look at the relationship between fishing effort and the capture per unit effort, right? So how many boats were involved in the capture, then you will see a completely different picture. You will see what I just said, that what is expected if you have if you increase the fishing effort, you will decrease the capture per unit effort, right? And so that's what we see here. And we can use this to estimate then what would be the fishing effort that will maximize yield and maximize it sustainably, right? You do this by extrapolating the relationship between the fishing effort and the capture per unit effort. And we have two basic models that do this, and they have different assumptions. The first model to be developed was to say, well, there is a direct relationship between fishing effort and capture per unit effort. That's the Scheffer model that you see here as a straight line. And this tells you basically that there's a point where the fishing effort is so high that it will drive the stock to extinction, right? So there's a limit to how much you can fish, because at a certain point you will fish all the animals and the stock is gone, right? So that's the Scheffer model. Of course, this is not the way things work in practice. We've seen it, some would say fortunately. And so Fox came up with another model that says, well, yes, the capture per unit effort will decrease with increasing fishing effort, but it will never lead to extinction, because it's really hard to capture every single fish in a given area, particularly if we're talking about the open seas. And so the Fox model is a non-linear model that makes an asymptotic approximation to zero as fishing effort increases. And you have here in this presentation these formulas will tell you how you can calculate the parameters that are needed in the Sheffer and the Fox models, right? So what you do, in the next slide, I'm going to start to show you the formulas behind the Fox and the Sheffer model. But the practical idea is that you use the relationship between effort and capture per unit effort to estimate the parameters that are needed in the Fox and the Sheffer models, right? And for easiness of working, I have named these parameters A and B. This is the equation for a straight line, right? Only that in Sheffer's case, the straight line is directly applied to the effort capture per unit effort data. In the case of Fox, because it's a curve, it's not a straight line, you have to take logarithms of these two variables, the effort and the catch per unit effort, and then calculate the parameters. So what can we do with it afterwards? Well, this image shows you the curve shape of the Sheffer model relating effort with capture per unit effort, right? And it gives you this parable where you have, as fishing increases, capture per unit effort increases, and then up to a point it increases, leading up to zero, right? So here you have the formula of the, Sheffer model, and I will not bother you with the mathematical details, but from this formula, you can solve this formula to estimate the fishing effort that will lead to the maximum sustainable yield, and you can calculate that sustainable yield, right? So basically what you're going to do in the practicals is you're going to take a very simple Excel sheet, and you're going to calculate the parameters from the models. And from these parameters, you will take my word or the bibliography's word that you can calculate the maximum sustainable yield and the fishing effort relating to maximum sustainable yield using these equations, right? And you're going to apply these equations to the data set, the previous data set, and estimate from the Sheffer model what would be the maximum sustainable yield and the fishing effort that produces it. And we're going to use the Fox model to do the same thing, right? And the equations are here. They have been extracted from the book references I gave you. And there is also here some answers, right? So that you can check to see if you get to the supposedly right conclusion. So that's all for this theoretical part.